Hello everyone. So in this video again, we have come up with a question pertaining to the kinds of which we actually see in various placement drives for various MNCs, like be it for off-campus placements or on-campus placements. Various MNCs or the tech giants such as Google, Microsoft, or even Amazon can take their aptitude test with this kind of questions in reference, and many service-based companies also take into consideration this kind of question. So more or less the patterns remain the same, whether you are going for any kind of aptitude test, be it in your core domain or be it any technological base or IT domain as well. So what we're going to do is basically we'll discuss a few kinds of questions as such in the video series as well, so that you can get a fair bit of idea as in what kind of questions to expect and what are the correct approaches towards this kind of question. So let's take a look at the first question on this video. The function f of x is defined as f of x equal to f of x minus 2 minus x into x plus 2. For all integers, the value of x, for integer value of x, and f of 1 plus f of 4 equal to 0. What is the value of f of 1 plus f of 2 plus f of 3 plus f of 4 plus f of 5? Okay. So let's take a look. Let s equal to f of 1 plus f of 2 plus f of 3. F of 5 plus f of 6. Okay. Now we know that f of 1 plus f of 4 equal to 0. So this plus this, they have to be equal to 0. Okay. From this term, so we can further write s equal to f of 2 plus f of 3 plus f of 5 plus f of 6. Okay. So this is the value of x. Now, f of 2 can be written as f of 0, because 2 minus 2 is 0, minus 2 into 2 plus 2, 4. Okay, so f of 3 can be written as f of 1 minus 15, just assume the value of x in all the cases. F of 4 can be written as f of 4. 2 minus f of 2 minus 4 into 6, that is 24. So here we have f of 2, right? So I'm going to substitute the value of f of 2 in this case. So this comes out to be f of 0 minus 8 minus 24. So this will be f of 0 equal minus 32. Okay, so I hope this one is correct. F of 5 will be 5, so f of 3 minus 5, 3 ja 35. No, 5 plus 7, 35. Sorry, my bad. So f of 3, we already know this is the value of f of 3. I'm going to substitute the same, being f of 1 minus 15 minus 35. So it will be f of 1 minus 50, and similarly for f of 6 we'll have f of 4 minus 48. I'm going to substitute this value, f of 0 minus 32. So minus 32 minus 48, it gives us 80. So it will simply be f of 0 plus f of 0 minus 80 minus 80. Okay, now as we know, we have all these values as such. I'm going to substitute all this value in this particular equation. Okay, in this equation of s. So what we have here, if we substitute the same, we get, let me sort of write it here, s equal to f of 0 minus 8 plus f of 1 minus 15 plus f of 0 minus 32. Okay, f of 4 plus f of 1. We don't need to add the value. Sorry, my bad. F of 4 is not needed. We have added f of 2, f of 3. So let's add f of 5, f of 1 minus 50, and f of 6. Will be f of 0 minus 80. what the simplification of the same would give us. 2 into f of 0 plus f of 1 minus 1, 5, 3. Okay, so this is what we have. Now, we already know that f of 1 plus f of 4 is equal to 0. So, therefore, if we substitute the value of f of 4 this one, so we have f of 1, we substitute the value of f of 4 in here, plus f of 0 equal to 32. Okay, so we know f of 1 plus f of 4 equal to 32. So I'm going to substitute this value, this particular value here again. So therefore, s equal to 2 into 32 minus 153. So therefore, the sum is s equal to minus 89, which is our answer. So I hope this is clear to you. It was a simple case of functions in general. So all we did was figure out the values of each and every function, and then subsequently we have just used substitution. So with that said, let's move on to the second question. So here, second question is pertaining to triangle. So let's take a look. In triangle ABC, the internal bisector of angle ABC and angle ACB meet at I, and angle BAC is 50 degrees. Find the measure of angle BIC. So let's draw a triangle first. This is our triangle, say this is A, B, C. Okay. Now, internal bisector of angle ABC. So this is angle ABC. So this is the internal bisector of the same. Let me just highlight the same. This angle is equal to this angle. Okay. This is the internal bisector angle ABC and ACB. ACB. So both these angles are also equal. Okay, they are equal. They meet at point I. See, this is point I. Okay. If angle BAC is 50 degree, so this angle is 50 degree. So what is the value of angle BIC? So we need to find this angle's value, angle BIC. Now here we can see I is the in center. In center of the triangle ABC. In center is basically the point where all the angle bisectors meet. So one important property as far as the in center is concerned is that whenever there is an in center, so therefore what we'll have is that angle BIC, this is an important property pertaining to in center, will be angle ABC by 2 plus 90 degree. So this is a property pertaining to in centers. So this lower angle, particular this angle will always be 90 degree plus half the value of the angle subtended at the extreme end. So this is what we have. So here for what we have is that 50 by 2 plus 90, that is 115 degrees. So I hope this is clear. This is simply a property of in center that we have used to solve this particular question. Now let's take a look at the third question. Let's move to that. So another question pertaining to numbers. So the difference between 3/5 of 2/3 of a number and 2/5 of 1/4 of a number is 288. Find the number. So let number equal to x. So therefore 3 by 5 into 2 by 3 of x minus 2 by 5 into 1 by 4 of x is 288. So it's nothing but 6 by 15x minus 2 by 20x equal to 8. If we take the LCM, it comes out to be 60. 4 is 24x minus 23 is 66x, 288. So it comes out to be 18x by 60 equal to 288. 10 9 6, so therefore x comes out to be 960. So hopefully all these three sums are understood to you. These are fairly easy sums except for the first one where we discussed review concepts about the functions. So hopefully all these points are clear to you. I suggest you go through all the videos for all the sums on your own and try to go through this video in case you're having any difficulty as many times as you wish. These are the kind of questions more or less that you'll come across in the examination whenever you go for any private company examinations or government examinations as well. You might come across this as well. Many companies like Microsoft, Amazon, whenever they have to conduct the aptitude paper, they give these kinds of questions only. Go through this and try to solve this question on your own with the video as a reference for your better understanding. So with that said, we have come to the end of the video and I'm signing off. Thank you so much.